How much does wood joint preparation matter? So I'll do a test. I'll take a piece of wood and I'll just glue another piece on there with a light sanding and without, and with some old stuff and some newer stuff. And switching over my tester for right angle joint breaks. So that was just 33 kilograms and it just popped right off right there. So I'm clamping this right next to a joint because I'm not testing whether or not the fibers are going to pull out of the wood. I'm just testing whether this sticks to the wood, and this is the sanded surface now. The lightly sanded one was only 1 kilogram stronger, but it did pull a chunk out of the wood, whereas the unsanded one did not. That one was a glue joint failure. This has got a bit more tarnish on it than the other one, so maybe it'll make more difference. This is the unsanded part right here. The sanded one on here actually did slightly worse, but neither of them pulled out any fibers from the wood, so both a glue failure. This specimen's got quite a bit more patina on it. This is the unsanded and then the sanded. .38-.9 unsanded, .34 sanded, so once again the slightly sanded one did slightly worse. And this piece has got a lot of patina on it, so sanding really should help there. And on this one, sanding it took it from 27.8 to 33, so helped here. So for two of my samples, the sanded ones did better, but for the other two, they did worse. So it's possible my quick sanding technique didn't help any at all, so now I'm playing the pieces down a bit to start with a brand new surface to see if that actually works better. And I also cut a bit off the joining pieces so I'd have a fresh surface for those too. And then gluing all my old test joints back together. And also two pieces of plywood that have also quite a bit of patina on them, and I'm sanding them more thoroughly. Well, on this fairly darkened piece, the sanding helped a lot. But this other piece of plywood, which is much less darkened, the sanding didn't actually help any at all. This is my first plywood piece. They both pulled out fibers from the plywood, but the sanded one pulled a lot deeper and it was a higher fail force. The second one, the sanded one, also pulled out a lot more fibers than the unsanded one, but the force was almost the same. And then retesting that first batch of samples, which I've planed down, so I've got a new surface on all of them. And here's those original samples in the same order as before. There's a tendency to pull out more fibers than originally, but was it stronger? So back to spreadsheets now. Each group is a separate board. Brown is the untreated, orange is the sanded part, and then yellow is retesting after planing it. And overall, except for this outlier here, a light sanding helps a little bit, or maybe not, but definitely the planing helps. And then here's the plywood pieces where it helped, but not hugely. So overall, I'd like to think that a light sanding and planing helps, but I'm also fighting the strength of the wood because even the untreated samples, most of them pulled up fibers, so really I'm very much limited by the strength of the wood, and the glue seems to be mostly strong enough to pull fibers out even without treatment. And one last batch of tests before I give up on this series. This is some hardwood plywood, which shouldn't tear out so easily, and the other piece is part of a bed frame, so I hope that's had lots of exposure, but it looks pretty nice. And again, 2 days later, I broke all of these test pieces just to be consistent. My hardwood plywood test pieces are actually some maple plywood that's maple throughout, and those were tables in a church basement. This is the top surface, kind of banged up. This is the bottom side, iron varnished, but it's had decades of atmospheric exposure. But looking at my data, well, this is the unsanded raw surface, and these ones were sanded, and I can't really say that it made much of a difference. Nothing beyond random variations. And then this piece was from an IKEA bed from the curb. No idea how old that was, but it's definitely been kind of probably exposed and touched a fair bit. And that's this data here, unsanded, sanded. Again, no difference beyond random variations. So I was really hoping with all these experiments I would come up with some kind of positive conclusion or at least something interesting, because that'll make it just a more compelling video. And it reminds me of a Veritasium video about is most published research wrong? Basically, the incentive is to produce something interesting because that gets traction, that gets your attention and all that. And of course, we YouTubers also want that, just like scientific publications. But in this, I just can't get anything out of it, and I don't have enough staked in here. Like, I've spent a few days on this. I don't have enough at stake to try to coax something interesting out of it. But imagine if I was a researcher and my career was staked on it, then I would have a lot more incentive to try to make something interesting here. But as it is, I just kind of give up. And I know a question a lot of people have asked me, you know, does it make a difference if you sand or plane or whatever the surface in terms of glue adhesion? And well, I went from probably decade-old plane surface to a freshly sanded surface, and I couldn't tell that it made a difference. So it appears that glue surface preparation matters a hell of a lot less than I thought it did.